Get ready to match the stars. Scully Mitchell, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Elaine Joyce, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rayburn.
All right, Johnny O. Everybody ready out there? How are the bright, humorous, attractive, witty, wonderful people here?
Not how are they? Where are they?
They're fine. They're we don't feel bad either. Yes.
Let's say hello to Laurie Holtzman and Tom Parker. Laurie's a very happy lady because she has won a lot of money. She has a total of $2,850 to her credit. That's irrevocably yours. No matter how badly you do on the day, we won't take it away from you.
Okay.
What are you going to do with your money, Laurie?
I don't know yet. I'm too nervous to think.
And just as the time expired last time, we met Tom Parker, found out he travels in Southern California. His family is here in the studio.
Yes.
And what else you want to tell us about you, Tom?
Well, I'm a 19 handicapper, and if I win any money, I'm going to take all the money and take golf lessons.
No kidding. If you play every day for 30 days, you'll improve your game.
Is that right?
I guarantee it.
Okay.
Okay, we'll see how you do, Tom, right after we see about this message for you. Hello there. Here we go. B. Round one. Tom, you have a choice, A or B.
A, please.
A it is.
Ooh.
Are you ready?
Yes. Yes.
The bionic woman said...
I'm so bad I was canceled.
That's the whole question there.
Isn't that wonderful?
The bionic woman said, when I was sick, I called in a TV repairman. It was a big mistake. As soon as he saw me, he wanted to take my blank back to his shop. What says that? When I was sick, I called in a TV repairman, and it was a big mistake. As soon as he saw me, he wanted to take my blank back to his shop. That's what the bionic woman said. Really? What does that mean on your front there?
It's just therapeutic living centers. Lovely people sent me this to wear.
Oh, that's nice. Okay, here we go, Tom Parker. The bionic woman said, when I was sick, I called in a TV repairman, and it was a big mistake. As soon as he saw me, he wanted to take my blank back to his shop.
Reactor?
Reactor? Is that one of her parts?
Yes. I'm sorry.
Reactor. Well, he says, you know, that's one of her parts. You think... Now, Tom, in all seriousness, look at these faces. Are these the faces who are going to say reactors? I ask you in all that. No. What do you say?
We're not even going to react to it. I said tubes.
Tubes is good. Yeah. That's probably the definitive answer.
Tubes.
Yeah.
Well, I've been having a lot of trouble with my car.
Yeah.
I'm not happy with it. Or the people who've been fixing it, in case you're listening.
I said body.
Body. You want to take my body back to his shop. Chuck?
I said boob tube.
Boob tube. Oh! Oh, a little play on words. That's very clever.
So
have you thought of a career in show business?
No, but I enjoy my car.
Yes.
Mr. Volkswagen?
Yes.
The rabbit.
The rabbit, yeah. All right, Elaine. The bionic woman said, TV repairman, big mistake. As soon as you saw me, you wanted to take my blank back to his shop. And Tom said, reactor.
Reactors. I thought maybe they would look.
They might fall for it, but they didn't, did they? Oh, she's getting there pretty, isn't she, there? Okay, show us your reactor, Richard.
I thought he wanted to take her chassis back.
Yeah, that's a very good one.
Chassis body, if it's not a chassis.
I'd take my chassis back to the shop. What are you saying?
I have been having a lot of trouble, too, and I'm not at all happy, Mr. Yamaha. I see transistors.
For what?
Transistor.
Oh, transistor.
Sure.
Yeah.
That's okay. A part. Isn't it a part?
See the way it goes, Tom? Yeah. That was a tough question.
Now
we got a couple for you too, Laurie. Nearsighted Norman.
We're having so much fun over here.
Nearsighted Norman ruined his record player because instead of putting on a record, he tried to play a blank. Now, this is a good one. And an easy one.
It is an easy one?
I think it is.
Okay.
A couple of good choices. Nearsighted Norman ruined his record player because instead of putting on a record, he tried to play a blank. Nearsighted Norman ruined his record player because instead of putting on a record, he tried to play a blank.
All I can think of is tape.
Oh, tape.
8-track tape, you know?
Yeah, I guess that would ruin the record player, but I think you kind of missed the point of it. Let's see if anybody over here got the point of this.
You think she missed the point of it? Wait till you hear these answers.
Yeah, really? Well, there are two or three really good choices here. Let's see if they come up. Yes. Go ahead, Scully.
A black plate.
A black plate. That's not one of the good choices.
I'm so embarrassed.
Yes, you should be. Now, what do you say?
Usually I would attack him, wouldn't I?
Yes, but yours is worse than his.
Give you an idea of how bad mine is. That judge can't be. I'm not in my night. I'm stroking him. Patting. I said a piano.
A piano.
I love a piano.
Well, there are two perfectly dreadful answers so far. Charles?
Unbelievable. Since that Claudette Colbert haircut, she's been impossible. Pizza.
Pizza is the answer. Pizza's a marvelous answer, isn't it? That would ruin your record player, wouldn't it?
Yes, absolutely. I always say what Charles says, pizza.
Pizza.
Licorice pizza.
Yes. Now, of course, there are other good answers, too. Let's see what Richard has.
A pancake.
Pancake is another good one. Anything round like that, that's not a record.
What's another good... white plate?
Yeah, I have a white plate.
It's only fitting.
Only fitting?
I've never seen a black plate.
I have.
Oh, sure, I have too.
I've never seen
I don't do this show every day either.
All right.
How is it going?
So there we are at the end of round one, and as you can see, there's a pitcher's duel going on here, and we'll see how the game ends after this. Here we go. Round two coming up, and if you're ready, we'll carry on here by asking Tom to make a selection.
B, please.
B it is. Everybody play since Tom didn't match anyone in the first round question. Oh. The second rounder for him reads as follows. Dumb Donald was so dumb. I'm going to tell you, he tried to smoke a camel, but he couldn't get the blank lit.
That's a good.
Tried to smoke a camel, but couldn't get the blank lit. That's how dumb he was. Yeah.
I want to do that one.
Oh, okay. Well, try something.
Good.
Why are you there?
Good. No, that's it. Listen, if that's the definitive answer, that's what we
Where do you have. Think he got it?
Oh, I see. All right, Tom Parker. Dumb Donald was so dumb, Tom. He tried to smoke a camel, but he couldn't get the blank lit.
The hump?
The hump lit. Now, you are booing that answer. Why? I would like to know why you are... That's a perfectly good answer. The butt?
The tail.
The butt.
Oh. That's a far hipper bunch than I thought out there. You're okay, you weirdos. Did you hear that? They're good.
You ought to book some of them.
Yeah, that's right. What do you say, Scully?
Huh? Oh, no. I said what the gentleman... You know, that was Elvis Presley's manager.
Who?
Tom Parker.
Tom Parker. Yes. That's Colonel Tom. Yeah, that's right. Yes, indeed. Isn't that interesting?
Yes. Yeah.
Not terribly.
You know, there's two people per square mile in the state of Wyoming?
Two people per square mile.
How? I know a lot of stuff like that. I'd do anything to keep from showing his ass.
Hump it is. There's one for Tom. May I see yours, please?
Certainly. Don't hump, smoke it.
Okay. All right, Chuck.
Now, my answer is funny because when I was in high school, I had a bad back, and, well, it was my nickname.
Really? No kidding.
He's lying.
Well, he convinced me. I bought the whole thing.
He looked at me and he said, how about you, Elaine?
He tried to smoke a camel, but he couldn't get the hump lit.
That's right.
That's right. We got four, Tom. So far, he's batting 1,000, Richard.
Batting 2,000.
2,000 now.
Hurry up, blow
now,
it,
the magic may end right now, Tom, but don't feel bad.
What's the matter with Arab? I said, no, I'm kidding. I said hump.
You did too. Well, look what happened to Tom, Lori.
Now,
you know what you have to do? You got to match every one to stay in the game.
She
and
will.
Here we go.
She will.
Jane say, you know how Tarzan beat chess? Well, last night Tarzan get drunk. Him beat blank.
Here, dear, I want to straighten you out on something.
What?
I don't want to hurt you. Jane was a person who was perfectly capable of sensible speech.
Oh, was she?
She wouldn't say, you know how Tarzan beat Chase last night.
Well, wasn't
night
she in the jungle
Mike.
For a long time?
No, she's an English lady. There she was.
Yes.
She would say, you know how Tarzan beats his chest?
Yeah.
Last night he beat black.
Well, then would you notify the writers? You see, they wrote it that way. She says, you know how Tarzan beat chest? Yes.
Please. Yeah. Notify.
Right. Okay, I'll take that to the writers and ask them to straighten out their syntax. Did you write this, Joel? You did. Who wrote it?
Oh, Joe. What are you expecting?
Elliot? Oh, Bobby. Who wrote it? Oh, Joe Neustein. Okay. You ready? Here we go. Jane said, my dear, do you remember how Tarzan used to beat his chest like this? Well, last night, Tarzan got very drunk. Him beat blank.
Me.
Me. Okay. Got to match everybody.
I'm playing very seriously now because I know there's a lot of money at stake.
Well, that's indeed there is.
I said me.
Okay, so there's one for her. Now, Laurie is saying to you, Brett, show us your me.
I'm playing very seriously, too, because I know there's a lot of money at stake.
I did the line already, Brett.
Oh. Me.
All right, that's two for her. Two for me.
Wow.
Three for me. Score is now 6-3. Laurie, she's gaining on you, Tom. Elaine, Jane say, last night Tarzan get drunk and him beat me instead of his chest.
I said drums.
Drums, so that means Tom Parker wins the game. Chest. What do you mean? Congratulations. That's better. You missed it by one.
I know.
The others all had it. It was a very tight second round. It would have ended up there 6-5 if we had finished it. Laura, you've got $2,850, and that ain't bad.
Thank
you so much. Great to meet you. Goodbye, Laura. While we're spinning her off, let's spin these messages just for you. Here we are with Tom Parker. Tom has won the game. He's got $100 now. And he's going to try for a big bundle of cash here. You ready for this, Tom?
Betcha.
You watch his show, you know how this goes, right?
Yes, sir.
Here it is. Now, we polled a bunch of people who came in here one day, lovely people as these are, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Put blank. Now, the answer they gave us most frequently, if you match that answer, you will get $500. Now, for matching their second most popular answer, you get $250. And then for matching the third, you get $100. And you can get some help here from our celebrities.
Richard, please.
Putting me on.
Putting me on, okay.
Benny?
Put him up.
Put him up.
Stick it out. No, I'm kidding. Put it in the slot.
Put it in the slot. Now, what, is that your answer? Put it in the slot?
Yeah.
Okay. Who was the last one?
Brett.
Put up or shut up.
Put up or shut up. Now, you think about it very carefully, Tom. Mm-hmm. Something else might occur to you that might be a little better than one of those three. It's entirely up to you. Put up or shut up, putting me on, and put it in the slot. Those are the three that have been offered to you.
Putting me on.
Putting me on. Okay. Let's find out if it's up there.
The real answer is just
what is it?
Put down.
Put down. Is that one? Or put up.
Put out.
Right?
Put out.
Okay. Put out.
Right now, it's...
You really are. A randy group. May we see the $100 response, if you please. Put out.
Well,
there they are. All right, let's see if we get putting me on under the $250 slot. Put down. Last chance for putting me on. Here we go. put on. Well, that was kind of a hard one, I guess. Now that I see it, though, put on seems very logical. Now, Tom, you're going to meet another player now. Let's welcome that person. Here comes Stella Phillips. Stella, you know Tom. Tom just stubbed his toe.
I know.
Yeah, it was a tough one. Stella, we welcome you. Where are you from and all that?
Well, I live in Carson now.
Yeah.
I am a service representative, and I'm single.
Uh-huh.
Ask if you want to kiss me.
Yes.
We have a very good kisser up there. Okay, that may happen. If you get up there and win some money, you may have a go with Scoey there. Whoops, there, here we go. Stella, good luck. A or B?
B, please.
B it is, and this is it. Richard Dawson said... He said, I got the worst luck in the world. Last night, I got an obscene phone call from blank.
Are you writing something?
No, I'm thinking.
All right. Okay. Very good. I didn't see yours. No. Okay.
So they get everything.
Fanny is just about ready, Stella. Have you been thinking about it? I'll give it to you one more time. Fanny?
Yes. You must write something on the card and put it in the slot. That's the way the game is played.
Come, sweetie. She's had a mild stroke.
I'm having a stroke.
Come on,
okay. Okay, I will. Just okay. I just sometimes have these blackouts.
All right.
You're going to have
Stella,
another one.
Richard Dawson said, I've got the worst luck in the world. Last night, I got an obscene phone call from blank.
Brett.
I would consider that lucky.
I would consider, yeah, that would be lucky if Brett would call. That's right. Yes, nothing wrong with that. What do you say?
I say Richard's a liar.
Be that as it may.
Nevertheless, there's one Brett.
Oh, one of his favorite people.
Who's
Mr. Nixon.
Yes.
Yep.
All right. And you, Charles?
Me.
Me.
Charles?
Yeah.
Yeah, I would. I thought that over. You're right, Charles.
Right. That's what I figured. He likes blonde.
Dawson said, I got the worst luck in the world. Last night I got an obscene phone call from...
A girl's glee club. I don't... Charles.
Charles. That's two of those.
Sorry,
The question's about me, so I know who made the call.
Oh, yes, of course.
It was the Mormon Tabernacle Choir. For the murder.
Hello, and this show doesn't even go to Salt Lake City, does it?
Well, certainly won't.
They refused it. We sent it, and they refused it. They sent it back. What do you say?
I said Brett. I didn't mean to, but I did.
Yeah.
I'll pay for this.
Not bad a beginning, is it there, Tom? You ready for yours?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Irving said, my boss at the delicatessen told me I'd never be able to fill his shoes. I showed him. I took his shoes and filled them with blank. Very easy one. My boss at the delicatessen told me I'd never be able to fill his shoes. I showed him I took his shoes and filled them with blank. Okay? Tom Parker, you ready? Come on, put those cards in that slot.
Right.
Right.
Got it.
I'll read while they're finishing. Irving said, my boss at the delicatessen told me I'd never be able to fill his shoes. And I showed him. I took his shoes and filled them with...
Corned beef.
That's what they sell in delicatessens. I mean, anything that you buy in a delicatessen would be a good, acceptable answer here. Right, Scoey?
And we got a heck of a meal coming up. I've seen four answers. I said cottage cheese.
Cottage cheese is one. What do you say?
I was thinking of something really squishy, like sour cream.
Sour cream is also very squishy. Chuck?
I was cheap. Mustard.
Mustard.
Chopped liver. Oh, good.
Chopped liver part two.
Yeah, fill those shoes with chopped liver and watch it squeeze through the toes. Go ahead.
Well, I don't eat at delis. I got confused.
Say it for
that. No, I'm not going to say it.
She doesn't want to say it, but I'll say it. She said manure. Isn't that dreadful?
I don't eat at delis.
So there we are at the end of round one. 2-0 score favor of Stella. And now this for you.
Oh, there's no time, so I just have to do a goodbye. 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 Goodbye.